another kind of bullshit that's closely related that I think, you know, deserves its own term. And this is what I've dubbed glass slippers. So if you guys remember the fairy tale Cinderella, in Cinderella, there's this glass slipper that fits on Cinderella, and the prince wants to find Cinderella, and so he's going to marry whoever can fit her foot into this glass slipper. So he goes around, and he goes to the two evil, or he sends people to the two evil stepsisters, and the evil stepsisters, not in the Disney version, but in the real version of the fairy tale, the two evil stepsisters actually mutilate their feet, they cut off their toes, they cut off their heels, and try to jam their bloody feet into this glass slipper. The plan fails because it's made of glass. I don't think that's in the original, but it is certainly a problem. And they're not able to marry the prince, and then eventually everything ends happy, if I remember right. This can happen with data visualization as well. There are some really beautiful structures for visualizing very specific types of information, such as these. But they can be misused. People can try to shoehorn other kinds of data into those structures. So we have a periodic table, Dmitri Mendeleev's beautiful design that sort of manages to integrate a large number of facts surrounding the nature of chemical elements and their interactions with one another and their structure. We've got subway maps that are sort of beautiful examples of data design that highlight and simplify the important information that they want to convey. We have Venn diagrams that have this very, you know, technical representation where you've got, you know, if you have A, B, C, D, E, then each of these overlaps, you know, corresponds to an overlap of certain of certain segments. And then, you know, since this is a biology class, I'm going to throw in a phylogeny. These are beautiful data visualizations that help us understand the relationships, the evolutionary relationships among species. The problem comes that these are so beautiful, and they're kind of cool, and designers want to be kind of clever, and so they take data that have nothing to do with these underlying structures, and they try to shoehorn it in to these structures, and it just plain doesn't fit, and you get bullshit. This is what I call a glass slipper. So let me give you an example. Here's the periodic table of data science. And a periodic table, there's a periodic table of everything, because everyone tries to put these things together. I don't understand it, because none of the fundamental relationships that are there in the periodic table are reflected here. If we zoom in, we've got different categories. We've got courses and boot camps and conferences, and we represent everything by two letters, because that's what you do in the periodic table. And it's just pure garbage. It's just sort of a list that's been assembled in some kind of nonsense fashion. There's no rhyme or reason to the fit of these data to a periodic table. It's a glass slipper. Subway maps. Everyone loves subway maps. So here's a subway map of Microsoft's acquisitions and investments. And so we can zoom in again and we see, I guess the lines correspond to different technology domains or something like that. I'm not sure whether they're ordered in any sequence whatsoever. I suppose if something lands in two technology domains, that's one of these, you know, places where two stops merge. But ultimately, a subway map, what's beautiful about a subway map is that the layout on the map represents a layout in physical space of the city. And there's no parallel physical space here. Even if these threads are in some way consistent and actually make sense to sort things that way, even if these overlaps are real, even if these are ordered in some meaningful way, we still don't have data that should be arranged as a subway map. What does that curve mean? It doesn't correspond to anything. What's this river? It's a glass slipper. This one's amazing. This is the internet marketing tree. This is a bifurcating tree, like a phylogeny. Looks like an unrooted phylogeny for the biologists here. It's not at all clear what this thing means. So look at this. Here's strategy. And strategy's nearest relatives, the clade of convert and multiply, and the clade of engage and attract. Now, it's interesting that those are kind of more related to strategy than to branding, and that multiply is more related to convert than engage is to attract. And in fact, convert and multiply are more closely related to strategy than engage and attract are related to strategy. I wouldn't have known any of that. And the reason I wouldn't have known it is because it's bullshit. Somebody just made it up. This structure doesn't match the data. they've shoehorned a bunch of words that they like onto an elegant data structure, and they end up with a glass slipper. Venn diagrams deserve their own category all to themselves. So let's look at this. This is some kind of business diagram, and we've got some important things: product excellence, effective branding, and promotional focus, and at their intersection, industry leadership, and revenue growth, and demand generation. When it all comes together, profit. Okay, so that sounds nice. I like it. But let's look at this. So why is revenue generation include promotional focus and product excellence, but is independent of effective branding? And why does demand generation have to do with effective branding and promotional focus, but nothing to do with product excellence? And why is profit a different category than all the other things that we're displaying up here? This is bullshit. This is just data bullshit being put together. They're taking a form that means something, and they're putting data into that form without respecting that meaning. Here's another one. This is the spectrum of user experience, and it's very pretty, and there's lots of nice words on it, like business analytics and visual design development and prototyping. And we can zoom in and we see user experience at the center, and style guide, and information design, and you try to figure out how it all fits together, and there seems to be no rhyme or reason to any of the arrangements, you know, let alone to the meanings of these overlaps. Another glass slipper. At the start of the class, I talked about how bullshit sort of reaches its apogee in the political sphere. Certainly true with Venn diagrams. They get used for just absolute garbage. This is something that that Mitt Romney put together, or Mitt Romney's campaign put together, and he says, as a candidate, this is middle class promise gap unemployment, as a candidate, Barack Obama promised that they were going to lower the unemployment rate. Then there's this result over here, which is the current unemployment rate, which is higher than what they were going to lower it to. And then there's this gap here of 8.4 million fewer jobs. But these bear no relationship to a pair of overlapping things. These are just three claims that have been pasted into the Visa? What logo? MasterCard logo. These are three claims that have been pasted into the MasterCard logo in order to make them look kind of data-y, graphic-y, trustworthy, right? A duck. Now, I don't want you to think I'm picking on the right. Here's Hillary. Hillary tweeted this out earlier last year. And so she's trying to make the point that, hey, look, most Americans support background checks, and so we should get on it and have background checks for guns. And so she puts out a nice Venn diagram, and she says, look, here's 90% of Americans. Here's 83% of gun owners, and then somehow their intersection is supports universal background checks, which makes no sense. And then I'd like to know if the majority of these 83% of gun owners aren't Americans, because they're not in that. Another duck, another disaster. And I'll finish with this one. I really have enjoyed collaborating with Thomson Reuters over the years, but either their graphic designer doesn't understand how Venn diagrams work, or this person was having a bit too honest of a day.